Parker's solar probe has shown us that the rotation of the sun influences the solar wind a lot more than we expected. Think of a blender making whipped cream. As the blades rotate, the cream will rotate around with the blades. Same thing's happening in the sun's atmosphere. Its magnetic field is so strong, it actually forces the wind to circulate. To our surprise, what we found is a rotational flow about 10 or 20 times larger than expected. This is going to impact our models that predict whether or not a coronal mass ejection flying out into space poses a threat to people on Earth or astronauts. One really strange thing about our sun is its atmosphere, corona, is about 1,000 times hotter than the surface. When we go into interplanetary space and we look at the solar wind, we've always seen small levels of waves traveling through the wind, kind of like being in an ocean and watching waves go by. As we got close to the sun, not only did those waves get stronger, but every now and then the spacecraft would get slammed by a giant rogue wave, a wave that was many times stronger than all the other waves. The speeds would jump up by about 300,000 miles an hour. And so it looks like these rogue waves might actually account for a large amount of the energy released by the sun into the solar wind. Our questions now are, is that enough energy to heat the solar wind and corona? And what on Earth at the sun is releasing these rogue waves into space?